Yes, 5 weeks away.
A little bit nervous. It's all going quite well though. It's a bit nerve-wracking after what happened last year, obviously, because that dented our confidence with it quite a lot.
It has traumatised the crew. Yeah, we did throw up our arms and run away. we had to, I think. But Sunrise just drew us all back again. We've got an amazing team. We all love working together. And it just seems to be that this is where we're all supposed to be at the minute, working on this. It's a great vision, and all great visions take time, and you know, we all have our falls, but we've got to get back up again. Failure is only when you don't stand back up and try again, isn't it? It's not the actually making the mistakes, it's the not looking at them and trying to see what other way we can do them. I think this is quite a healing journey for us. Whether it's a good thing or a bad thing, we're all still here and we're working on the next sunrise.
It's going really well, and it's really exciting. This is when it gets really exciting, because it's just kind of really snowballing and flowing now. And yeah, and we'll be on site in about 3 weeks' time, so it's not far away. The theme of this year's sunrise is 3000 BC meets 3000 AD. So it's going to be like caveman versus galactic wizards, kind of hunter-gatherers versus techies, kind of, yeah, it's like tribal pixies to kind of futuristic space pirates. And that is a lot of what Sunrise is about as well. There's the kind of the ancient wisdom that we celebrate a lot of and have talks on and investigate, and that loads of people are interested, Mayan civilizations, Egypt. And then there's the kind of future vision, the kind of transition of the Venus Project, or the how we're going to live in the future, and the technology that can make our lives easier. And there are some people that believe in a low-tech future, some people that believe in a high-tech future, but everybody's thinking creatively about the future, so this theme will be really interesting.
Yeah, we're hoping that the weather holds, of course. But even if it doesn't, the site's much higher than the last site was, and we've got amazing sort of wet weather contingency plans in action. We've built a whole hard trackway around the site, and the site's on a hill itself, so any water that would come will drain off into a sort of field that will be empty.
Ticket sales are going really well. We've still got tickets available though. So encourage people to get them now if they're going to come, because they may sell out. And it's a limited capacity this year because we're moving to this new site. We've moved to this new site, which we've got the license for today. It feels good. There are no objections either, which is always good. We've got really good liaison with the locals and the council and the police, so it's great, yeah. And it's a gorgeous organic site, rolling hills with spring water through the taps. It's a nice site, but because it's a new site, we have a limited capacity on it.
The site itself is really beautiful. It's a 300-acre organic farm, and all the sort of milk and dairy produce, we're trying to source things as locally as possible, so not only will it be totally organic, it will also be locally sourced. There's a really nice farm shop on the farm that sells local organic fruit and veg too. It just fits in so much more with our ethos, and it's a site that we feel that we'll definitely be at for a few years. We're very, very pleased that we've got this site. The farmer is very helpful for it with us as well, and he's really looking forward to it. He's going to be running his own cider bar. And we put in the hard trackway there. I mean, there could be possibilities that we put in sort of permanent compost toilets and things. What we're moving towards is a permanent site and having these things in place all the time. So we can put up wind generators, and we can put in compost toilets, and we can create permaculture gardens on a permanent basis. This site, we feel, is the next step to us obtaining our vision and creating a sunrise that's not just about a festival, but is a year-round community and place and a showcase for people to come and see these alternative ways of living in action.
The main stage is the Chaiwala stage, which is an indoor stage, and there's Yeah, there's an outdoor bandstand this year. There's going to be lots going on. And we've just confirmed the bays and three daft monkeys, which is great to add to the lineup. And there's still more to come, I think. There's still more juicy tidbits to come to the lineup. We've already got Martha Tilston and Back Beyond and Dub Pistol Sound System. And I think Ned and Math from The Egg are coming to play in the Bimbleon as well. So we'll see, it's still unfolding. And we've got a Tibetan monastery on site this year, and there's some Tibetan monks who'll be performing a Sam dance, which is a Tibetan masked dance that's illegal to practice in Tibet.
The relationship with the authorities is very good. The council has been behind us since day one. You know, they were behind us all last year as well, and all this year, and they really want it to happen. I think they kind of realised that festivals are one of Somerset's greatest assets. So they see us as being a responsible organisation that really wants to work with them. So, and that's, we're very committed to building up that relationship with both the council and police. You know, there's the argument of, is it revolution or evolution? Sunrise is really about the evolution. We've got our goal in mind and what we want, but the point is that we've got to get everybody on board for that to happen. The whole of the UK community has to be on board for change to happen, and sort of give them the information that they need, and then they can give us the framework that we can work with that in. And of course it's a bit slower, but I do think that things are changing for the better, and that more and more people are realising that they've got their bit to do and are wanting to do that. And the Transition Town movement is very much a big part of that, and we're calling ourselves a Transition Festival this year. The Transition Town movement is about taking the steps that are necessary to become self-sufficient, more energy efficient, more food efficient, and bringing, decentralising things and bringing them back down to a local level. So it's very much what we're about, and it's also about the steps. It's not about, okay, we're in this position, tomorrow we're going to be totally off-grid, self-sufficient, you know, that's just pie in the sky. It's about each individual steps, right from people making their boilers more efficient to creating a vegetable plot in an inner city garden, right through to people living on the land and making that choice. And what Sunrise wants to do is be a source of information for all those people, not just the radicals.
It's a very family focused event, and the kids area's always got a lot going on there. It's a festival within a festival for children. Yeah, lots of interesting things for children of all ages, from toddlers through to teenagers. And there's a lot of people who bring very young children, which is nice.
In terms of people bringing us ideas, we're so open for that. We want to be at the forefront of all the new ideas related to sustainable living. So while, you know, we're taking the small steps, we also want to go more radical as well, and bring in things like, you know, the solar power fridge, and, you know, help people that are working on things like this that are very important to what we see as our future vision. So all new ideas are really welcome, and we really want to work with that.
I know that Sunrise has an organic food policy on the site, and that's also an organic drinks policy. And in the bars, all the beer and wine and most of the spirits that you'll buy are all organically produced. And this year we're being supplied by Vintage Roots, who are the largest supplier of organic wines and spirits in the country. And the lager provided by Freedom Lager, that's brewed in the West Midlands with spring water. And we're going to have a Sunrise organic ale that is brewed in Froome by Milk Street Brewery, and it's called Ra, after the Egyptian sun god.
They're UK based, and because they're organic and they're small, you know, we feel that they're good partners to have for us. and I've tasted some of the products and they're really nice.
So all the alcohol pretty much is organic, where it can be. So obviously there's the odd thing that we can't source organically, but we achieve about an 80% rate on the organic policy, which is great. Sunrise's unique flavour is that it's really rootsy. It's about people really being inspired and trying to consciously create their lives and their futures. Sunrise provides a kind of networking opportunity for people like that, and also like educational. People can learn about alternative technology, they can learn about how to live off-grid. Sunrise is just about bringing together lots of great creatively inspired people to one place, and everybody co-creates what happens there. And it does have a really beautiful vibe, and that's made by all the people that come. There's a couple of different talks areas. There's the Avalon Rising area, as always, with kind of earth mysteries and esoterica and all kinds of magical things going on there. And there's the sustainable living tent. And the Sunday of the event is dedicated to the Transition Towns movement, which is quite in line with a lot of our philosophies, because Sunrise has been powered on renewable energy and since it began, and we try to be as green as possible and impact the land as little as possible. And the Transition Towns movement is about moving away from an oil-based economy and about local resilience and community. And so we're dedicating the Sunday of the event to the transition movement, and there's going to be talks from a guy called Sean Chamberlain, who's written a book called Transition Timeline, and Jeremy Leggett from Solar Century, and Nick Rosen, and lots of people. It's going to be very inspiring. There's going to be lots of debate as to where to now for society and for us on this planet.
On that day, we're going to have a recycled clothing parade. So what would be great is if people could bring all their old clothes in, and we're going to have a clothes swapping tent where they can put their old clothes and swap them for a new outfit. And also part of that parade is going to be a competition for the best outfit made from totally recycled material. So it'd be great also if people could bring an outfit with them that they've made, and the prize will be a couple of bottles of organic rosé wine. And then we'll do the parade the whole way around the festival, and also in that tent will be lots of information about ethical clothing, organic cottons, and other forms of things like hemp and things, and why it's important that we have got to change our buying patterns where clothes are concerned, because it's quite alarming, the cotton industry. And that's really important to Sunrise, is to sort of highlight the issues connected with that. Well, the most ethical form of clothing is actually recycled clothing. You know, everybody every day makes a statement with what they put on. It's something that we very often forget about, because we don't kind of consciously get dressed in the mornings. Did a 5-year-old child sew the buttons onto my jumper, or you know, where exactly did the leather come from my shoes? It's just not things that we really think about. But they're very important because they affect so many other people's lives. On the Friday as well, there will be an ethical fashion show where a group of local Glastonbury dancers will be showing the funnier side to the fashion industry. The fashion industry is very much geared towards young girls and how thin they are, what labels they're wearing on their clothes, and there's so much advertisement and hype and peer pressure that create things like eating disorders and just low self-esteem, and we really want to take the stress and the pressure out of it. Yeah, because when you're that age, it is very stressful, you know, and there's a lot of pressure on teenagers.
Individuality and creativity rather than being a sheep and everyone dressing the same, but a celebration of people's individuality and personal expression. And that's what you get a lot of at festivals, people dressed as freaks and flowers and crazy kind of outfits, men in tutus, and you know, it's brilliant. It's like the best and the most mad come out at festivals. And so the fashion show will help celebrate people's individuality as well. It's being a lot of fun.
But this is it, this is what we want to do. We want it to be really fun, but also get across a serious message.
And it ties in well with the transition theme of the event on Sunday, and it's going to be kind of called Fashion in Transition, because all of the designers that are coming along are local designers or a small kind of individuals who design and make their clothes. I mean, with the materials they use or the way they do it or the ethical policies they have.
I mean, this year will not totally get us in the black because a lot of people have swapped from last year, because that's ticket money that we're not getting this year. But it's a long-term project, or by the end of this summer we'll be a much more watertight, stronger organisation that has a very firm foundation. And that's what this year is about. It's about building that foundation, and then we can work onwards from there. You know, all these things take time and take a lot of work, and it's the groundwork that we're doing at the minute. We're very pleased that we've managed to create a situation where everybody that wanted either refunds or swaps from last year have got them. So either they have swapped for Big Chill last year, or they've swapped for this sunrise, and then some people of course wanted refunds, and we've honoured that too. So we've managed to create a situation where the people that support Sunrise, we've been able to keep them on board. You can't please everybody, and there's been sort of admin glitches here and there, but we've really tried our best to work through those, and we're at the sort of top of the mountain. Now, there's been no ill feeling. The community's been very supportive, especially here in Glastonbury.
The state of the imagination, and everyone will be the imaginatives. Because it is a bit like being a government organising a festival, because you have to do the one-way systems, and you have to do the road networks, and you make sure the security's dealt with, and it's like, and you can do things wrong that upset people, and you have to make sure everybody's felt listened to and heard, and everything's working smoothly, and so it's a bit like, yeah, it is like a micronation, the independent state of Sunrise celebration. That's key to a lot of it, a celebration of life and of culture, and creating sustainable, conscious communities, inspiring people to do that through connecting with each other.
It is very exciting, and you can tell by the way we're talking about it that we are getting quite excited about it.